Welcome to everyone to this live webinar series about Tomezoral. I would like to thank Green Acre for his kind invitation and all the participants. Let's introduce myself. I'm Eugenio Luigi Orio, medical doctor and PhD in biochemistry. Moreover, also I'm laboratory medical doctor and president of the International Observatory of Oxidative Stress. These are non-profit scientific network that involve at least 3,000 researchers living in 35 different countries. Our main goal is to translate into the clinical practice the basic knowledge on free radical, antioxidant, and oxidative stress. Moreover, I'm also the president of the University of Lifestyle Medicine in Italy and editor-in-chief for the European Journal of Aesthetic Medicine and Dermatology. Most of my research was done in Italy, in Greece, Argentina, Brazil, and Japan. In Italy, I'm also part of the scientific board of the Italian Society of Nutraceutics, SINUT. Let me to introduce the main topic of today, just to understand how Tomezoral work, oxidative stress. I try to provide you a synopsis of these big topics only in 10 slides. This is my challenge today. Oxidative distress, this is the bad side of oxidative stress, is an emerging health risk factor, because of its asymptomatic progression. It is like a dynamic that can explode in any moment. To understand oxidative stress, we must remember that the human body shows an ubiquitous, evolutionary, well-conserved adaptive biochemical system. This is the redox system. This is spread in all parts of the body, in the brain, in the eyes, in the heart, in the intestine. This redox system works like a tau, which oxidant component yang extract electron from antioxidant component yin, by this way modulating homeostasis and survival. Redox system functions are under the control of genetics and epigenetics. This system is an adaptive system. In order to understand how this system works, I represent here the legend William Tell. In this case, the archer is the machinery, generally one enzyme, that produces reactive oxidant species that represent the arrow. And these are in ill stress condition, reach and regulate the function of biological target, represented by the apple. Antioxidant look in a green color, allow the arrow to reach safely the target, thus avoiding the possible unwanted side effect, like to kill the eagle or to kill the baby. So this is happening in oxidative eustress condition, the arrow reached biological target, generally is a transcription factor. In distress condition, the antioxidant modulation is not able to preserve the damage. In this case, we talk about oxidative distress. So it must separate good reactive stress, oxidative eustress, from oxidative distress. This is the way of the mechanism of the functioning of our redox system. Redox system react to many different challenges, physical, chemical, biological stress, like in the skin, and depending on environment, lifestyle, our genetic and epigenetic, this system exchange electron and realize the production of free radical and other oxidant species that we use like a signaling molecule. Look at this, like a message of mobile, or like a weapon we use to defend our body against bacteria or cancer cells. So this system realized at the end of the history an adaptive response. If this is response is optimal, then oxidative and stress derive and we survive, we adapt to our environment. So if the adaptive response is abnormal, oxidative distress may happen. This means disease, early aging, and death. Today has been widely recognized that oxidative distress syndrome involves many organ and tissue and closely correlated to early aging and skin disease and many diseases, at least 100 diseases. And especially oxidative stress maybe is the common bridge between different hypotheses that until now have been proposed to explain the mechanism of aging. So really oxidative distress collect all the hypotheses. The final point of many hypotheses, epigenetic hypothesis, telomere shortening, dysfunction of psychoneuroendocrine immune system, garbage, this means accumulation of toxin, and finally inflammation, together with casualty, of course. And one important key factor in aging process is GSH depletion, the depletion of glutathione, as I will explain to you later. Today, oxidative stress can be measured because the problem of oxidative stress is don't show any symptom, any clinical picture. But today, a panel of tests is available. And among these tests that have measured the YAN and the INF part of this red ecosystem, we can measure, or even in the clinical practice, oxidant part and antioxidant part. Just I would like to underline one suitable biomarker of oxidation is the monoaldehyde. Monoaldehyde is the end product of lipid peroxidation that happens in our lipids. While in the other side, among the antioxidants, very important biomarker of antioxidant status are the glutathione peroxidase and glutathione reductase. Both enzymes are inside of our cell, and we can check in laboratory by measuring on sample of a red blood cell. And we can fight in some way age. How to fight the age? We should follow positive phenotype, like all the people that live in the area of a blue zone where the longevity is common. And to reach our successful aging, we need to take information from this population, because today the current model of age bring us to reach to a delay, a progressive loss of a function. But these people realize, like eternal youth secret, they reach long life and drop just in the last, the function drop last in the last stage of the life. In order to reach this successful aging, the key factor are exercise and nutrition. And so the control of redox system play an important role together with the control of inflammation and microbiota. And sometimes supplement can support us. In the past, supplementation mean deficiency or increase the need. So I have a vitamin deficiency and take fruit, vegetable, and supplement. After 30 years, this concept changed to nutraceutical. Nutraceuticals are between drug and food. They play, they are part of food or concentrated part of a food, extract of a food, which physiological action to support the body and its function. And they realize true prevention activity with a strong health effect. So today, people take this food, part of food, not only for deficiency, but to live better and healthy, even in the absence of deficiency, or following a normal diet. And this approach today in the clinical practice is going to change. For instance, in the past, to treat dyslipidemia, doctors start with lifestyle change, then nutraceutical in case are accessible, and then drug. Today, everyone must start to lifestyle change and start as soon as possible with nutraceutical and slowly introducing case drug. And searching for a solution, maybe glutathione represents a big challenge, a big opportunity for our wellness, for our health in the body and in the skin. Which is glutathione? Glutathione is a peptide, what means a small protein derived from the concentration of three amino acids. Look, this glycine, a cysteine with a sulfur group and glutamic acid. It exists in two different forms. In the left side, it is a reduced glutathione, the biological active form of glutathione or glutathione monomer. And on the other side, you can sound on the right side, oxidized glutathione is this dimer glutathione or oxidized glutathione. These two formulas are interchangeable, so we can change this formula to other formula, vice versa. The difference is the creation of our disulfide bond. And glutathione is synthesized in two-step process, so that require ATP and two enzymes, one ligase and a synthase. In the first step, this enzyme bound the first amino acid, glutamic acid, to cysteine. In the second step, another amino acid is added by the second enzyme, glutathione synthase. This process requires ATP and a cell spends a lot of energy to produce glutathione. So one important point is to try to recover glutathione after oxidation. Look at the best way to have a safe way to maintain normal level of glutathione. Glutathione is required for eyes, where in the length, in the crystalline, they reach the very, very high, around 10 millimolar, but only in the heart, in the lung, in the liver. And also we can detect usually glutathione inside the red blood cell, where the level is 2 millimolar. Glutathione, important point, is under the biosynthesis of glutathione is under control of hormone, like insulin. So in case of diabetes, we expect a low level of glutathione. Moreover, also under stressing condition, glucocorticoid may activate this enzyme. And we need glutathione, but glutathione derive from this biosynthesis or by supplement. Indeed, it's not possible to take glutathione by food. And glutathione modulate many activity. First of all, it's a regulate redox function. It is, in fact, is the coenzyme of glutathione peroxidase. It's scavenger, remove free radical. It's a chelator of iron and prevent the production of free radical, and also support the activity of many common antioxidants like CoQ10, vitamin E, vitamin C. And moreover, it prevent the oxidation of hemoglobin. Second point, glutathione show also conjugating ability because it's involved in the detoxification phase 2 of a reaction. Is a powerful chelating that removes heavy metal and toxicity and modulate a lot of enzymes involved in the homocysteine, the biosynthesis, polyunsaturated fatty acid, and inflammatory immune diseases. Glutathione, in fact, is commonly not as a detoxifier, but glutathione is much more than a detoxifier molecule. As I told you, glutathione peroxide, glutathione is the coenzyme of the enzyme glutathione peroxide. Under distressing condition, our body releases peroxide. Peroxide are very toxic. So for this reason, our cell activate glutathione peroxidase. This enzyme use glutathione like coenzyme and remove this peroxide and that are released like common alcohol. But after react, glutathione become oxidized. For this reason, a specific enzyme, glutathione reductase, recycle this glutathione and make it two hydrogen atoms. So glutathione reductase allow to regenerate glutathione after oxidation. Another part of glutathione is keep from glutathione transferase in case of intoxication. At the end of this reaction chain, one enzyme, glucose, stephosphate, dehydrogenase, regenerate finally glutathione. Moreover, glutathione is also the coenzyme you, an important point, this is the role of glutathione reductase. Glutathione is also no immune response modulator. In fact, this is a schematic model of phagocytosis. Our leukocytes use phagocytosis to remove bacteria or virus. And this chain of reaction starts from the production of one free radical, a superoxide anion to kill bacteria. And then start a radical chain that led to the killing of bacteria and the release of common water. But in this radical chain of reaction, glutathione play an important role because they allowed in some way that detoxification of H2O2, because H2O2 must work to kill bacteria, but can kill also ourselves. Then glutathione peroxide remove H2O2, hydrogen peroxide to not harmful H2O. Moreover, this chain of reaction generate iron. And iron is responsible for Fenton reaction. Again, glutathione is a chelating of iron and prevent also free radical generation. So we need a good balance of glutathione. Glutathione show also some important feature is used commonly in skin lightening because they work at different level in the pathway that lead from the amino acid tyrosine to eumelanin. Eumelanin is the dark pigment. Glutathione work by inhibiting specifically two step of this biosynthesis and improve the level of pheomelanin, that is the light pigment. And glutathione show powerful activity in the pecking order, that mean the order which of a potency, the order of a power of all antioxidants. Glutathione play an important central role. In fact, it allow to regenerate after oxidation three important antioxidants, like ubiquinone, dehydroascorbate, and tocopheryl radical. So glutathione support many endogenous and exogenous antioxidants. Moreover, glutathione can be potentiated by the other antioxidants, especially vitamin B3, vitamin B2, lipoic acid support glutathione, while glutathione support other antioxidant. In this interplay, glutathione reductase play an important role in order to recycle continuously glutathione after act. Glutathione depletion is a big problem, may affect any organ and tissue. And this is an updated version of the function of a possible indication of glutathione. Glutathione is involved in many functions and has been proposed in clinical practice in the treatment and the prevention of a lot of diseases, starting from infertility, diabetes, successful aging, until cancer, and look also in skin disease, in inflammation. Glutathione, so the question is how to increase our body level of glutathione by considering how much important it is glutathione for the health of our cell. This schema shows the possible nutraceutical approach. You can take direct glutathione supplement by oral, sublingual, intramuscular, intravenous way. This is the first way. Second point, increase the availability of a precursor. Take more cysteine or acetylcysteine or whey protein. till the point is stimulate the biosynthesis by activate this enzyme ligase I told you before, stimulate this activity. And point four, reduce the burden of oxidant by use common antioxidant and detoxificant. And finally, to stimulate the activity of the level of glutathione reductase. It this looks one very amazing way. So we don't use any way, but we only recycle our glutathione itself. And in this wide range of opportunity, carotenoid showed a very close relationship with the metabolism of glutathione, because they are sure involved in the stimulation of the glutathione reductase, and many growing data show that the carotenoids are potentially useful in the stimulation of the activity of the ligase, the key enzyme that put together the first two enzymes of glutathione. So carotenoid, especially this new class, discovery class of carotenoid, colorless carotenoid, attract in some way the attention of research and clinical. But what is carotenoid? Carotenoids are a wide family of lipophilic compound that derive from the condensation of this unit, this like Lego. And this unit is isoprene. This molecule is very suitable. It's very able to condense with the other molecule and realize long chain, realize also cyclic some ring. And by this way, this isoprene can generate carotene. Carotene are like a hydrocarbon, only carbon and hydrogen. Among these, you remember very well beta carotene, lycopene, and emerging role are recently assigned to phytoene and phytofluene that are completely different because they are colorless. Moreover, the other side, isoprene can condense to generate xanthophyll. In xanthophyll, like lutein, zeaxanthin, astaxanthin, they are colored compounds that contain also oxygen. They are ubiquitously spread in many vegetables. They work basically as a quencher of singlet oxygen. Singlet oxygen is an active, energetically active form of oxygen. They can eat any molecule, starting from the membrane, start from a living. And and then until now, at least 800 different molecules have been identified. Look, the human cannot synthesize, so we need to take this by food. And this is a very nice review on colorless carotenoid, like a promising biological active carotenoids. And carotenoid is widely distributed in the human skin because they participate to the protection against UV light, blue light, and support the activity against radiation, against singlet oxygen. And this is a world panel of the activity until now recognized to carotenoid. They are not only modulator of redoxing function, they enhance immune response, prevent inflammation, modulate cellular cycle, and especially they control in some way also the apoptosis and show a final anti-mutagenic activity. And how to improve the level of going back our first question. Unfortunately, dietary intake of glutathione is considered normal inefficient. So one important way is to support the glutathione reductase activity, and tomesoral exactly work by this way, but activating and stimulate the activity of glutathione reductase, so that allow to recycle oxidized glutathione to reduce glutathione. This biological form, active form of glutathione. Tomesoral white, let's me to introduce this fantastic innovative product derived from tomato powder. Tomesoral white is a white tomato powder that is rich in phytoene, phytofluene, and also lutein, zeaxanthin, and a small amount of flavonoids, which aim is to support our health by modulating many biological activity and especially the metabolism of glutathione to make glutathione more available for our cell. This tomato in particular, because they're open pollinated, non-hybrid cultivar, so they are eco-sustainable and are pure strain of the fruit. And it is, I was really surprised when hear about this tomato, because in my mind, I know only yellow tomato and red tomato, which color depends from this pigment, this lycopene, the first one, and beta carotene. But between this, I discovered also this white tomato. White tomato show this are naturally rich of this colorless carotene, phytoene and phytofluene. Look the difference, they are each molecule are four units of isoprene. And then the small difference is only one double bond between phytoene and phytofluene. They are inside, they are colorless because they in some way buffer the effect, take the light exactly in the spectrum of visible UV. For this reason, they are colorless. They are the precursor of both beta carotene and lycopene. So everything starts from this basic molecule. They are the parent, the grandparent of the final molecule like carotene and lycopene. And they, from this there are different color and different biological properties. This is a classical form of phytoene. Look at the difference of phytofluene. And we know the benefit and no benefit are antioxidant function, anti-inflammatory, UV protection, and also are well known, normally have a good bioavailability because they are lipophilic molecule. And why this tomato valley is so special? Because it's derived from this specific tomato species not available commercially that are especially grow to produce such carotenoids and small amount of flavonoids. They have high content of this colorless carotenoid. They may support skin and beauty and our wellness, our resilience, a key word of aging or successful aging, and also show all the classic activity ascribed to antioxidant carotenoid like anti-inflammatory gene regulation. That really was shown to increase intracellular level of glutathione by stimulating the activity of glutathione reductase. Again, the enzyme that recycle glutathione from its oxidized form to reduced form. This increased level are directly bound to the skin benefit and protection. And also, not so bad, this powder shows a delicate tomato taste and a smell, and because it's sweet and very low acidity, that make this powder potentially candidate to put inside some food or beverage. One interesting study was done by Greenacre in London. Greenacre asked to a big research institute to do this study in vitro in fibroblasts. The fibroblasts are very common cell, very easy to cultivate. They're an important part of our skin, of our main, is ubiquitous cell of our body because they are part of a connective tissue. The first aim of this study was to take this cell and undergo and evaluate specifically the safety profile, because before to use any supplement, any drug, we need to demonstrate that it's absolutely safe. All the Latin mention primum non nocere, that first of all, please don't cause damage. So the first set of experiment in vitro was done on this fibroblast with a cytotoxic test. This graph show the toxicity of potential evaluated potential toxicity of tomesoral with this test, the MTTSA. This one is very easy, simple to measure the ability of any compound to induce a toxic effect on the cell. As you can see, mostly all concentration of tomesoral 100 microgram, 200 microgram, until 500 microgram was safe, don't induce any toxicity. Toxicity was reached only at a high level of tomesoral. So the conclusion, until 500 microgram per milliliter, tomesoral is safe, according to the result of this cytotoxic test on fibroblasts in vitro. Moreover, in selected another set of experiments was aimed to evaluate this other parameter here, IC50. This is in some way an indicator of safety and how much in this case the test evaluate the percent of availability of a cell and demonstrate that the value, final value calculated for is one good value. The good value, so if the 50 was around 2 milligram, this is a good value for a good indicator of safety of this model or this extract. Moreover, this is another important experiment. The same cell of the previous set of experiment undergo an oxidative challenge. So the cell was enter in contact with a solution of hydrogen peroxide. Hydrogen peroxide look reduce the percent of availability as expected because H2O2 is a very strong oxidant. But look what happened. If we put in the media of a cell, we put growing amount of tomesoral prevent the unwanted side effect, this damage. So until 500 microgram, we confirm this data, until 500 microgram for milliliter, this cell was able to recover after this oxidative challenge. This is another important point because the cell can not only resist but recover after injury that normally happen in our body. So the final conclusion of this set of experiment, tomesoral white was shown to support cell recovery after oxidative stress challenge. Another similar test was related to lactate dehydrogenase. Lactate dehydrogenase is an enzyme normally found only inside of the cell. When LDH appear in the medium, it means that the cell are sick, so lose vitality. Again, you can see in this other set of experiment, LDH level was measured by photometric test. After oxidative challenge, the level of LDH increased like expected. But if the cell were incubated before with tomesoral at a different concentration, they maintain, they don't release. So in some way, tomesoral was able to prevent this damage. And for this reason, today we conclude that tomesoral white supports cell viability and vitality even after oxidative stress challenge. But the most important result was done by studying the enzyme glutathione reductase. In this set of experiment, glutathione reductase was measured by photometric method. This is the level of activity in normal, in baseline condition, non-treated cell. After challenge, oxidative challenge occurs, after this injury, the level of glutathione drop. But if a cell are incubated with growing amount of tomesoral white, you can see that even growth concentration Tomesoval increase the reductase activity until two times compared to the baseline value at the highest value of 500 micrograms. So this Tomesoval significantly increased the expression of glutathione reductase, and this effect was dose dependent until 5 microgram of milliliter, that means two times higher than baseline value. Another important test was done to evaluate the antioxidant power of Tomesoval. I mentioned you that one effect of free radical is lipid peroxidation, is one on the effect of oxidative injury of lipids, especially on cell membrane and circulating lipoprotein. And this lipid peroxidation process led to a destroy completely polyunsaturated fatty acid until molecule, which name is malonyldialdehyde. This is a small molecule, only over 3 carbon atoms. And we use in my laboratory, in any laboratory of redoxomics, malonyldialdehyde is a suitable biomarker of lipid peroxidation. So in this set of experiments, researchers evaluate the baseline level of MBDA, because NSA, even in normal control, produce oxidative stress. Look what happened after a challenge. After the oxidative challenge, which H2O2, the level of MBDA grow two times. But again, if you put the medium Tomesoval, Tomesoval is able to prevent the release of MBDA. That means it's able to prevent lipid peroxidation. Lipid peroxidation is related to many, many diseases, including atherosclerosis. Atherosclerosis depends from oxidation of circulating lipoprotein. And so phytoene and phytofluene show also some direct effect. Don't forget, so some effect of phytoene and phytofluene are related to glutathione, but other are direct. In fact, phytofluene, because they are the carotenoid, protect against sun our skin, are able to decrease the UV-induced erythema, show a high level of protection against oxidative stress. And look, is responsible for inhibition of LDL oxidation. LDL oxidation is one important process involved in atherosclerosis. And also phytoene and phytofluene alone are much better together with lutein and zeaxanthin that are xanthophyll, that they are involved also in the prevention of eye diseases because the ability to filter blue light. Moreover, some studies show that phytofluene and phytoene, this intake like a tomato drink, after 12 weeks led to decreased erythema in response to UV radiation. So some effect of this carotenoid are direct effect, like from other carotenoids. Moreover, phytoene and phytofluene treatment in vitro led to a decrease of inflammation, protect again erythema and DNA damage. Don't forget that normally carotenoid is also gene regulator. And also another study on lutein and zeaxanthin show that this carotenoid and xanthophyll in this case improve many skin features like skin elasticity, skin hydration, and modulate positively skin surface lipids. And another set of experiments look to demonstrate anti-inflammatory activity of Tomesoval. You know that tumor necrosis factor alpha, TNF-alpha, is one of the master pro-inflammatory cytokines that many cells release under stressing condition. And in this set of experiments, the cell undergo to injury. Oxidative challenge, oxidative injury by H2O2. And look, after this challenge, the level of TNF-alpha grow around two times compared to baseline value. But look, again, if this cell was incubated with Tomesoval, only 100 microgram per milliliter, the minimum dosage, this was able, this treatment, to prevent the release of TNF and to and thus prevent inflammation. And we know that how much important in inflammation. We become old, we become aged person because a combination of oxidation and inflammation, the oxy-inflammation process. And also an important part of our body's extracellular matrix. Extracellular matrix is between cell and blood vessel and play a major role. Extracellular matrix mediates the exchange of oxygen metabolites between our blood and our tissue. So unfortunately, during the age of because some disease, our extracellular matrix become damaged. So this specific set of experiments look to demonstrate the effect of tomesoval on extracellular matrix, because one of the big problem of aging and also some sickness is the activation of this enzyme. This enzyme, matrix metalloprotein S12, is an enzyme that catalyzes the degradation, that destroys extracellular matrix. So we need to take under control this enzyme. So in selective experiment, tomesoval white was able to prevent the release, the expression of this enzyme. This is the, again, this is the control, this is the level of metalloproteinase 12. After injury, the level grow until 4 times. But if we put in the culture, medium culture, tomesoval at 100 milligram, the microgram, this is the low dosage, the lowest dosage, was able to prevent the release of this enzyme and then to protect our extracellular matrix. And another important point, you know that physiological wound healing and similar repair process require blood supply, so require a new blood vessel. And vascular endothelial growth factor exactly is one transcription factor physiological involved in the generation of new blood vessel after appropriate stimuli. In this set experiment, the level of VEGF was measured. In the control, this is a normal level, is 0.6. After oxidative challenge, the level of VEGF dropped dramatically. But if cell was treated with tomesoral, the level of VEGF was not impacted. In some way, tomesoral was able to increase VEGF expression until the physiological range under oxidative stress stimuli indicate a potential to improve vitality and regeneration, because more blood vessels mean more blood, more oxygen, more nutrients for our skin and our body. And so this study strongly indicated that tomesoval white is a hormone, white tomato powder rich in phytoene and phytoflavone, and together with lutein and zeaxanthin, it could be a potent agent in enhancing the production of glutathione reductase and also in other biological response with final aim to improve our beauty, our wellness from within with multiple skin and health benefit. I would like also to underline how much important is the synergy of all the components of tomesoval and the pleiotropic action. This is an advantage of nutraceutical. Nutraceuticals are eclectic molecules compared to common drug. Nutraceuticals are between food and drug and show lack of pharmacological activity. But when you establish to take nutraceutical, you need to follow some regulation to take constantly and to follow a precise protocol. Actually, the recommended dosage of tomesoval is between 300 to 500 milligrams. This is the optimal dosage because it warrants this biological effect. As soon as possible, it will be made available in different formula, starting from a tablet and capsule, a tablet. And moreover, it's also suggested trials are in progress to make available on the market also some food because of the quality of this tomato extract, the taste is possible to mix this powder to common food or beverage. This is an intriguing question because it is the real aim of functional food. We reproduce the effect of a common food, but is like a powerful food. So tomato, in conclusion, white is like a catalyst of inner glutathione, foster healthy resilience and beauty from within. And we look to a new research to will maybe establish much more the mechanism and how to, and also the indication, the multiple indication of this new and original nutraceutical based on this colorless, amazing story with this colorless carotenoids and also this the effect on glutathione. This is one part of references, and thank you for your attention.